complain about. It is February 13th, 2012, and I wanted to do this video because I found out that Ben and I are having a baby today. So I wanted to just kind of speak on that for a couple minutes. This is the second time that we've been pregnant. The first time ended in miscarriage back in November, and it's been a rough road, but we're doing okay with it. And then back in January, we were told that we could start trying again. Didn't get pregnant in January, and I was kind of depressed about that because I just wanted to get our family moving forward. And so our church started to do a fast. And as I was reading through the fast, every day we had to read part of the gospel, and I came across a story that I found so much comfort in and really based the whole end of January and the whole month of February so far on. And because I based my life on this in the past couple weeks, I'm just really, really excited to see how God worked in our lives today. So I'll read the story and then I'll kind of explain what happened with us and where we stand now. So it says, "When Jesus had finished saying all of this and hearing of the people, he entered Capernaum." Now, I'm really bad at actually pronouncing the names of the city, so excuse me. "There, a centurion's servant, whom his master valued highly, was sick and about to die. The centurion heard of Jesus and sent some elders of the Jews to him, asking him to come and heal his servant. When they came to Jesus, they pleaded earnestly with him, 'This man deserves to have you do this because he loves our nation and has built our synagogue.' So Jesus went with them. He was not far from the house when the centurion sent friends to say to him, 'Lord, don't trouble yourself, for I do not deserve to have you come under my roof. That is why I did not even consider myself worthy to come to you. But say the word and my servant will be healed. For I myself am a man under authority with soldiers under me. I tell this one, go, and he goes, and that one, come, and he comes. I say to my servant, do this, and he does it.' When Jesus heard this, he was amazed at him and turned to the crowd following him. He said, 'I tell you, I have not found such great faith even in Israel.' Then the men who had been sent returned to the house and found the servant well." Okay, so I just read that story about Jesus healing the man's servant because the man asked him to, and that really spoke to me and touched me a lot because I found that all I had to do was ask God. In Jesus' name, I had to ask God and for me to be pregnant, and it would happen. I had to ask in full faith, though. I couldn't somewhat or half-heartedly ask. And so I did a lot of praying on this, and I just felt a peace come over me, and I prayed this prayer saying, "Lord, you know, thank you for sending Jesus to us to die on the cross. That way I can come to you directly to tell you my wants and my needs and the things that I have in my heart." And I really truly believe God put the desire in my heart to have a baby. And I knew it was the right time for us. So I asked him with everything I had, and from that moment on, I just was in full faith saying, this is going to happen. I'm going to get pregnant. I'm doing the things that I need to do to get pregnant. And I've prayed to God, and because I've prayed to him and asked him, and I know he has the power to do it, just like the centurion said to Jesus, say it is and it will be done. And Jesus really honored him by saying that he had the faith that because he asked and because he believes like that, it will be done. And there's so many times in the Gospels that Jesus said, ask in my name and you will receive. And so that's what I did. I had lunch with mom a little over 2 weeks ago, and I told her, I said, I'm going to get pregnant this month. I fully believe it. I asked God, and his word is truth, and we can't accept nothing but the truth. And so I believe that. And then last night, all night long, I kept dreaming about taking a pregnancy test. And so woke up at 4:30 and told myself to go back to sleep, and then woke back up at a little bit before 6, and just had the desire to go and take the test. And before I did, I laid in bed and said another prayer to God, saying, thank you for letting me be able to come to you like this. And I've asked you, and I fully believe that you're going to allow for this to happen, and that I'm going to give this baby to you. It's yours. And so I went into the bathroom and took the pregnancy test, and within a couple seconds, the results showed. I have it in a little plastic bag, but you can definitely see here that I am pregnant. As soon as I saw the two lines, my whole body just started trembling. Of course I've seen God work, but I have never been so emotionally tied to something, his work before. And so my whole body was just shaking, and I went in there and woke Ben up and told him, and I feel very, very blessed, and just, I feel like God's smiling upon me, because I had the faith to ask him. And so I feel very, very pleased with how everything turned out, and I can't wait to just shout it out and to tell everybody about the miracle that happened, and that God really did work in my life and in this baby's life. I've got to wait a little while, a couple weeks, until Ben feels comfortable about sharing the news as well. So that's my story with that, and I just wanted to record it on the day that I found out, because I didn't want to forget anything that happened to my future child. I'm very excited for you. I know that God's given you to me, and I hope that I can be everything, be the whole mother that he expects me to be for you. And for anybody else who's watching this, I guess the takeaway note is to ask God for the things that you are needing and wanting, and the desires of your heart. Ask, and without any doubt, ask, and it will be done. And in Jesus' name. You never win. But the voice of truth tells me a different story. The voice of truth says, do not be afraid. And the voice of truth says, this is for my glory. Choose to